This is a short video to help with the extended learning review for the 5.L.3.2 genetics lesson. In creating the rebops, you will want to look at the PDF that is attached in the lesson plan. Before the day of the lesson, you will want to make sure that you have prepared your thumbtacks and painting them red and green by using the provided permanent markers, or you may purchase paint on your own. You'll see in the example, we even used foil stickers. Given the marshmallows a few days to air dry will help them be stiffer and easier to manipulate when doing the project. Once creating the dam and the sire, the male and female, you can put them into a cage and share with the kids how you captured them creatively. Allow time for students to record the phenotype, that is the physical trait that is observed in both the dam and the sire, and allow them to compare and contrast the differences, physical differences that they can see. Using the printed karyotypes, students will pair the chromosomes together and realize that there are dominant and recessive genes for each trait. Once the students have finished recording the phenotype and genotype for the parent rebops, they'll turn the chromosomes over, and because they are matched by size, they can draw one from the male and one from the female to fill in and create an offspring rebop. Encourage students to be creative with the display of their rebops, and they can even hide them around the classroom. But have the students do a gallery walk so that they can see the different traits represented, noting that the phenotypes and the genotypes are completely different, even though they came from the same two parent organisms.